Elaine, do you want to talk about the new structure?
Yeah, I would like to talk about the new structure. I think most of you follow it, but it's not so easy to understand the first time. So I'm going to be short, and I'm going to try to sum up the changes we are going to try this year. It all started with the impression that it was difficult for the member to get involved in OIDEC, because you can be in the council, but then it's a lot of responsibility, a lot of time, and not everybody can afford that. And if you were not in the council, it's difficult to be active and bring some project and make the thing happening. And it was like for 4 years, like nobody wanted to be in the council, not enough people, and it was always difficult to convince people to come and jump in the council. We decided to change the council role and to make it easier for the people to engage in OIDEC and start something. And we did it like this. From Sunday, every people who want to be active in OIDEC can join on Basecamp, what we call a circle. There are 7 circles, and every circle is for a purpose. Like there is a circle called finance. Yes, there is a circle called finance, another community animation, another governance, another OIDEC meeting. So if you are interested only in one point, like you are interested in OIDEC meetings, like, but not about OIDEC finance or not about OIDEC community animation, you can join OIDEC meeting circle, and there you will take the initiative you need so that OIDEC meeting are organized, and you can take the decision in this circle with the people that also are interested in OIDEC meeting. And that that makes two things easier. The first thing is you don't have so much responsibility and you don't have so much time to give, because you can ignore all the other circle. You are in OIDEC meeting circle, but you don't really know what's happening in the other circle, and that's okay. And the second stuff is you're going to have the power to take the decision. You don't have to wait that the council that maybe you don't know say yes or no to what you want to do, and that makes everything easier for the people. And that was a problem in the council. Yeah, in the council we have a regular meeting. So most of the time was 2 every month, and we discuss everything. And so it takes a long time because we have to discuss everything. And sometimes I don't care about some stuff, and I want to focus only on one theme. And with the system of council, I couldn't. So then with this system where the decisions are taken in the circle, it makes everything easier for the people to take part of the in be active in the association. Then there are 2 problems. The first problem is yes, but then what happened? Because if I'm not in every circle, maybe there will be decision taken that I don't like and I'm not aware of. So against this problem, we have 2 mechanisms. First mechanism is that every strategic decision are taken in general meeting like it was before. And anyone can say, if I want to take a decision in OIDEC meeting circle, and someone say, no, I think it's strategic, he just has to write it, no, it's strategic, and then the process of decision stopped, and it will have to go to the general meeting. So that's the first way, so that it's not going to be a little circle who decides some very, very important and strategic things. And the second mechanism is that if a decision is taken in OIDEC meeting circle, then we have to. There will be a Basecamp team where all the decision will be listed. So you have to list your decision also in the OIDEC here. And then, if someone wants to be aware of every decision that are taken in every circle, it just have to subscribe to this Basecamp team. So that's the first was the first problem. And the second problem is if nobody in the circle OIDEC meeting is aware of what's happening in other circle, can be a problem because we are not sure that the circle are doing stuff in the right direction and in the same direction. And we need a strong coordination, especially because every circle can take decision apart from each other. And that's the new role of the council. So the council stays, the people are elected exactly as it was, but the big change is that the council has no decision power anymore. The council cannot decide something. They can. The only thing the council is making is that they coordinate all the work that's happening in the different circle, and then it will. So it will be that before you were elected as a council member, but you didn't really know what you will do in this council, and it was like we decided within the council what's doing what, and now it's going to change. You are going to be elected as a council member with a link with a specific circle. So for example, I candidate for the circle to be the coordinator of the finance circle. And I know it will be this task. And that makes also easier to candidate to council, because you know exactly what you're going to have, like a circle. Yeah. And then you only have to, you have to do two stuff. You have to know everything what happened in the circle you are, if you are a coordinator, a council member. So you have to know everything what happened in the circle, and also you try to be at every coordination meeting, which will happen probably every month. So it's easier for active members who just want to work on a specific subject to do it, and it's also easier for the council members. They don't have all this responsibility and pressure they used to had, and they can focus on only one theme. Yeah. So it's the spirit of the change. We didn't change the general meeting process. We didn't change. It was also possible before to make more than one general meeting in a year. So we used it, and I think we will have to make more than one general meeting in a year. But that's the only change. And the rest didn't really change. We had a problem about who is going to be official officer for the administration, because in Germany you need to design to tell, okay, these three people are the official officer, and we decided to make it like very separately from our governance system. These people are elected, and they are sometimes they have to sign some document, but they don't have any decision power in because they are official officer. The decision is somewhere else. They don't have anything to do with decision making. Yeah, and the rest didn't change. Like was already. Yes, I want to. So oversight committee was already here. Auditors was already here. Bookkeeper also. I also want to just to say that it. We will talk about it in the general meeting. But an example of problem that we have in council, it was like nobody wanted to be responsible for the finance stuff. And because nobody applied for counseling with that in mind, and nobody had the desire to do it, and we did a mistake. We didn't see that we have to make more than just tell the bookkeeper to do the bookkeeping, and so we are not ready yet to validate the budget 2020 because of this failure. I think with the new system will not happen because the finance circle will be responsible for doing this job. Yeah, the people who are in the finance circle are going to be responsible for that. I want to again to say, the coordinator, they have no responsibility. They don't decide anything. It's the people who are in the circle that decide and have the responsibility. So the coordinator, the people who are in the council, they only know everything what happened in their circle and take part in the coordination meeting. That's it, nothing more. And just to finish, we need three more candidates for council. Council members, so I hope there will be spontaneous candidature, and we also need two people who want to be auditors. Like we will talk about it also later. And Mike was auditor; he's here. He can talk and explain maybe what it is very shortly. The thing is, it didn't work well the last year, and Mike is really upset about what happened, and I can understand. So that's a new structure, and I'm very excited, and I'm going, technically, if you want to be part, that's important, if you want to be part of a circle, you have to join the Basecamp team. Dorian, but I explain, and then, so you have to join the Basecamp team of this circle. And how do you find it? You can go on OIDEC headquarters on the Basecamp team. Then you go in documents, and there are the overview of every Basecamp team, and you will find the Basecamp team of every circle. So you just click, and then you are part of the circle, and you can make you can take part of the decision, and you can take part of discussion that are happening there. Dorian, you wanted to say something.
Yeah, I'd like to add that about the financial circle, that is going to be a very important circle for UDEC, and that people are in there who have some ideas about how to do that on a professional way, and that they can come up with the goods, say, for the AGM. So that the financial circle is taking care of the verantwoordelijkheid, the responsibility for a good report, which everybody can understand and that it's fitting. And I hope that in the future we can add the auditors inside that circle just to make it together, and that we make a beautiful circle round. You say no, but maybe in the future it can work well, but we'll see. And the AGM is going to be the the circle who's gonna say if it's correct and good. That was how I feel it. And every circle is gonna help the council and the AGM to make a proper organization on all different layers.
Yeah. Thank you, Dorian. I think the idea of auditors is that they are not in the circle finance, so that there are two independent circle, and it's not possible that some people make some arrangement or strange stuff and nobody see it. Like auditors, they are auditoring, I don't know the name, the work of the circles, the finance circle, and they cannot be, it's a conflict of interest if they are in the finance circle. I have to say that I decided for this year to be in the finance circle, and it's not what I like the most, but I because I've seen that there are not so many people, I will this year make the job. But with as many people as possible, please join the finance circle. Maro already said she comes, and I'm very, very happy about it. But if there are some other people, it's better. Thank you very much.
Okay, Baudi, don't worry. We still have 25 minutes. So we have 25 minutes open for anyone to ask questions or to give their opinion on something. What do you think of what you heard? Do you need some clarifications or anything, or you want to ask something? Just open your microphone. Feel free.
We were so boring that it's only three people who stayed.
Nobody left, not one single person left.
I have a question, Guillaume. I'm sorry, I'm not very informed, but is it an idea to get more into the circles in this conference, if people want to talk about a bit more about what every circle stands for, what you expect of them? Could it be in an agora room or in open space? And I can ask the members, is there need, or do people think that's a good idea?
Yeah, I want to do it like at the same time like the presentation of the candidates into a general meeting. I don't think we will have a lot of proposals this time. I think the people are waiting to see what's going to happen. So we will have time in the general meeting, I think. I would suggest we do it like at the same time that the candidate presentation, and it makes sense because anyway we will say, okay, so now there is a council seat for finance, and we'll talk about finance and ask if there are some other people who candidate. So we can do that here. Maybe it's good to make another workshop. I don't know. I have the feeling that the people are, it's very quick, boring. Like the people, if they have an email and they have the list of the circle and they say, okay, I'm interested in communication and lobbying, then they click and they are in the Basecamp group and they can see. But I'm not sure like a whole hour about this will bring something, but that's why I didn't propose. But we will talk about the circle in the general meeting tomorrow anyway.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, Christiana has raised her hand, and then Baldi.
Yes, hello. I'm not sure if it's the right moment to talk about that, but I would like to point out that maybe if we, first, before saying that, please let me apologize for not being so active in UDEC. I mean, I consider myself active in my original chapter, UDEC Greece, but I'm not so, I don't really participate so much in the UDEC mother organization. So I will say something, but I honestly cannot commit that. So I would like to point out that maybe now that we are discussing the finance circle and everything, we should consider to apply for some projects that could be funded by other organizations and increase mobility inside the organization between schools or staff or students, and also mobility for conferences and trainings and practices, etc. I think that this could be a win-win situation, because we will get more, we will become more sure of who we are, what do we stand for, by sharing the experience with different countries and different students and different schools. But also it will give us a voice for other people, other educators, other students who don't work or don't even know what is a democratic environment, and they can have other type of experiences, because the reality of the majority of schools are not democratic schools, are very oppressive schools. And it is important to show them that there is another way possible. So I think this could be a win-win situation. Again, I don't know if this is the right time to discuss about it. And again, I'm sorry, I'm proposing that. I cannot even to do that. So.
Baudi?
I just had to add something. I think, and Doriane, you know about it as well, I guess. There's a new university in the Netherlands for people to be educated for democratic education. And it's one of the founders is Bas Rozenbrand, and he is already working for more than 20 years in the Netherlands for democratic education schools. And I'm not sure if it's in Dutch or in English, maybe both. So if people looks for something like that, you can maybe find it, and or we can help you to find it anyway.
I know Baz has just brought out a third edition of his lovely book, Co-Creating School with Children. A beautiful book. I recommend it to everybody. I'll be talking a little bit about it on Sunday.
Co-Creating School with Children, you said?
Yeah, in English. I can't say it in Dutch. But in English, it's called Co-Creating School with the Children, A New Morning. It's a lovely book. It's not a new book, but it's a new edition. I think the book's been around for about 15 years, but Baudi will know better than me.
Thank you, Derry.
Yes, thank you. Thank you, Maro.
Thank you.